to know how certain your uncertainty is? Are you not always sure how to avoid mistakes in the calculation? And are you baffled by auditor's question about the documentation?
I demand to stop the production immediately. You have 5 measuring devices and only 1 report. Where are the 4 missing reports? Huh?
This video is about uncertainty in general, and I will discuss certain steps in applying the usual standards. We need to start with few boring definitions. The measurement task is usually the part to be measured, together with the identification of measured parameters. A typical example would be a shift cage, together with, let's say, 2 diameters, their circularity, and the distance between 2 faces. The measurement system is usually 1 measuring device that was chosen to measure the part to execute the measurement task. In some cases, the measurement system can be more than 1 measurement device. This happens when the operator has several instruments to choose from, or typically in an inline measurement where the measuring operation is parallelized to 2 or more measuring devices. And finally, the Validation Act validates the capability of a particular measurement system for the given measurement task under a specific measurement process. Typically, the shaft, the measurement task, is measured on the shop floor with 1 measurement system and in the lab with another measurement system. Although the measurement task is the same, the measurement systems differ, requiring separate validation acts. Also, it is possible that 1 measurement system is being used with the same measurement task, but in different measurement processes. This is, for example, when 1 measuring device is being used, but sometimes we measure the part immediately after the machining process. But sometimes we let the part to be cleaned and temperature stabilized to reduce variation for special checks. This is 2 different measurement processes that also require separate validation acts.
I mean, where are the 4 missing reports?
The auditor did not understand that the 5 devices were part of 1 measurement system and that reporting them separately would mean to ignore the gauge variation uncertainty.
The uncertainty is the gauge R&R. I read that in the Auditor's Daily last Sunday. Just make the ISO 22514-7. That's it. It's not so complicated.
The uncertainty of measurement is a parameter that indicates the dispersion of measured value. Every measured value is burdened with uncertainty. That is bad news. The good news is that with a given probability, the uncertainty is finitely big. It is a general practice that a measured value is complete only when it is accompanied by its uncertainty. That is one way of looking at it. The other way, the industrial one, is that the uncertainty does not have to be noted under the condition that it is sufficiently small for the task at hand. And this is exactly where the capability comes to play. When the measuring device is capable, it means that its uncertainty is small enough, given the tolerance, the process capability, or whatever we want to relate it to. Generally speaking, we always have to estimate the uncertainty. And only if we have something to relate it to, we can express it in a form of capability. This expression is not direct and needs some simplifications here and there. There are two extreme approaches to finding the uncertainty. One I would call a bottom-up, where we would look inside the measuring device and all its relevant components, and we would build a multiphysical model of how the dimension of the measured part gets translated into the displayed measured value. The second one would be not to care at all about the guts, and only observe the performance of the device at certain conditions.
The proper approach is, as always, somewhere in the middle. The industrial world tends to lean more towards the second one because it is easier and more universal, and applies it also in circumstances that are not completely suitable. This is the world of the VDA5, the ISO 22514-7, and, if you are not at all demanding, the AIAG MSA.
Just make the ISO 22514-7. That's it.
It's just one of the many simplified procedures. Uncertainty estimation is, after all, a field of physics, and there isn't a standard for energy conservation law or the theory of relativity. There doesn't have to be a standard for measurement uncertainty.
The only good reasons for standard is when people want to understand each other outside of the field of general knowledge. Like when they want to make use of simplified uncertainty procedure to be applied on an industrial scale.
It is a good thing we started to talk to the auditor rather than just oblige his drivel. He is not actually a bad person. He is just used to see the world through the simplified quality guidebooks, and people were usually nodding in pretending consensus. It seems he slowly starts to reflect on his ways. Or isn't he?
I see you have not calculated the bias here. And what do you mean by comparative? I've not seen that in my handbook.
Let's see what is the difference between absolute and comparative measurement. First, this is not device specific. There can be one device that measures few absolutes and few comparatives. The important point is if master is at all used, and if it is used to set or adjust the measurement device.
In comparative measurement, the device only measures the difference between the part and the master. In such cases, it is pointless to use this master to check the bias of the measurement. In absolute measurements, the master is not needed. This is typically in cases where the scale has a fixed reference, like measuring the length with the scale starting from the base at zero, or where the measured dimension is itself relative, like a difference of the extremes in roundness.
Typically, you will see this in devices that use the master to measure the diameter or length. But the circularity is usually absolute.
Oh, attributive devices. It's cool you're using some of the good old snap gauges. I know those.
Well, no. This is different attributive device. I regret showing him our CCD pattern recognition checkpoint.
We are used to see the attributive measuring devices often as a simple go, no-go plug gauge or snap gauge. But this is not always the case. There are very complex electronic devices, typically with optical sensors, CCD cameras, eddy current probes and other, that check for assembly completeness, crack presence and other such parameters, and typically send out either an OK, not OK signal, or OK, defect type code.
These also need to be regarded as attributive, or more generally, discrete measuring devices. Quite often, these devices also use masters in a form of typical defects that can be seen during the production. In such cases, they are comparative, and it would be a big mistake to test them for bias or measurement process properties with these masters.
In connection to this, let me remind you of one property of the uncertainty estimate per the VDA5 or per the ISO 22514-7. Implicitly, they are only concerned with the overall performance of the measurement system for the given measurement task, and they are not at all concerned with what is inside. This is both positive and negative. It simplifies the capability evaluation so it can be used on an industrial scale, but it is lacking the metrological insight, which is needed to choose or design the measurement device. The metrological insight needs to be translated into specific uncertainties first, and only then, using them as the type B, it can be used in the outlined evaluation.
Finally, there is something he feels strong about. The type A and B evaluation. Have a look at the second part to see how the auditor reacts.